So I want to build this counting mechanism, which I've drawn up a CAD model for, and it's based very much on one of these little counter wheel mechanisms. This one's out of an old tape deck, and they all work pretty much the same way with the special little gear that does the carry for one digit to the next. So I've printed out my one-to-one templates from my CAD model, and I've already prototyped some of the mechanisms. So for instance, here is my counting mechanism. It's got this special partial gear, which on one side has only got the four teeth, and that working together with a special shaped notch on here allows for the carry. So when one digit wraps around, that increments that by two teeth, which in turn increments the digits on the other wheel. The more tricky thing to test out has been my increment decrement lever. So here's my first prototype, and if I move that lever to the right and back, that increments this wheel that you can see there. And if I move it to the left, it decrements it. So I've refined that a little bit, and here's my second prototype. And again, works the same way, except you don't need a scroll saw to cut this one out. So I cut out my templates and arranged them as tightly as I could on odd-shaped scraps that I've got. So after 40 minutes on the bandsaw, I got all my gear shapes cut out. So I just drilled these gears out so that they just barely slide freely on the shaft and spin freely. And the next thing I need to do is I need to cut away every other tooth to a certain depth. And I'm going to do that on the drill press. So this side panel has got this big opening on here just so you can see the inside a bit more. It's not really necessary. I'm going to cut that on a scroll saw, but if you don't have a scroll saw, you can just cut in a slot from the bottom and then cut all around. It won't matter if there's a gap in the bottom because the bottom base is going to hold that together. So here's checking some of the gears, so I'm just gonna use some bits of shafting and put them into this frame to see how they run. Now these two work perfectly together, but I've actually had to do a little bit of sanding around the edges here because I didn't cut to the line everywhere. Here's checking one of those funny partial gears. This disc has to fit into the notch in here, so let's put this on here. And that seems to work. So I should have not so much play in here and then enough for that to go through here. And that's a bit tight. I think I'm gonna sand this a little bit. And here's checking that this gear works. It's a bit tight here, so I'll have to sand that. Right about here. So here's checking this gear again. It's essentially these two teeth here that do all the advancing. And then we put the other layer on top of here, this layer here, and that makes sure the little gear doesn't turn when we're in between, because otherwise this guy could just be free running when nothing is happening. See, without this guy, if we're turning too fast, we can just spin that gear up. So now that I've got this shape fully tweaked, I can glue it together with the next layer on top of it. I really have to make sure this is really tweaked because this edge here becomes impossible to sand once it's glued. I'm running a bit low on the 3/4 inch plywood, so I've been gluing together various scraps to make the double thickness layers for the big rotors that have the numbers on the outside of them. Next, I need to make these little things here. Those are actually, they don't advance anything, but this one down here just provides a detent for the click stops, and the one on top makes sure this hook here is always in the right orientation to grab it. And they both have a little bump on there. And I could cut these out of plywood, but I'm just going to use some solid wood. And I've already cut this on the table saw to be about the right thickness. And by using solid wood, I get a smoother surface, and I've already got one straight edge. So I'm just gluing my pattern to the edge of that. So I've cut this lever out like this, but next I'd need to put this template on here and cut the profile from the other side. But because I've got this bump on here, that makes it difficult. So I know this part here is 6 millimeters wide, so I'm just going to use my calipers to score a line on here. And then I know where to cut, and for that last little line here, I'm just going to freehand that. Before I cut this part off, it's important to drill a pilot hole through here, all the way through here, because otherwise once I cut that off, that mark is gone. So I haven't actually changed this lever in my design, so I'm just going to use that one for the actual one, except I need to glue some bits of reinforcement to that. So there's a disc that needs to be glued on the back just to give the screw a bit more hold. And let's put a nail through there just to make sure I've got the pilot hole centered. Good. And another disc goes on here for another screw to reinforce. So this lever mounts on here and this pivots on here. Now for hinging that, the nails worked out pretty good, but they don't attach anything. And ideally I would use a screw that has a smooth part of the shank like this one. But in the right size, I cannot find any screws like that. So I'm just using some 3/4 inch number 4 screws. And I'm relying on the countersink to hold it in position. And these need to be countersinked so that the head is just below the surface. And so this part can still turn freely. That's good. Now let's attach that on here. So far so good. So I've just attached this lever, which provides detent with the ratchet wheel. And then this one here keeps the lever centered with this little notch here, and also makes sure this thing tilts in the right way so that these hooks actually end up engaging that wheel. Now I'm attaching this with 3/4 inch screws like the rest of it, and I've actually countersunk these below the surface with another drill, just so that you don't have to buy yet another length of screws. Using longer screws would be better, but I'm doing it this way just to make sure you can. So I've just hooked up the rubber band, and let's put the sprocket in here. And let's see, that's in there, and let's try that out. It seems this is a bit tight. There we go. And in the other direction. So that all works. And that gets attached to the first rotor, and I'm putting a little cardboard spacer behind it just to give the mechanism a little bit more slack. So let's make sure that goes on exactly in the right position. And screw it down. Now the next part here is a bit tricky because I need to make sure that this wheel and this wheel will actually ratchet the next wheel onto the next digit right with one click of this here. So that needs to be lined up with the wheel here. So the easiest to do is to make sure this detent is exactly between two digits. And that should put us right in the middle of flipping the sprocket here. That means this part here needs to be exactly here, where it's just in the process of flipping the next digit with this wheel. So that tells me the position that I need to screw these things down at. So I can just mark those holes with an awl. So here's my increment lever turning the first rotor. And I've got the special wheel on here, and that engages with this here. We've got the flat part here, and that goes against here. And then let's put the next gear to engage with that. And now as I increment, and then the next one we have the carry. So now they both rotate, and now we're rotating just one for the next while until we do a whole 10 turns, 10 increments. And here it goes again. Now with the first and second rotors here, I have to now make sure that when this next thing goes on here, when this ticks over, that'll also be in the middle of this one here, so that when it uses the next sprocket to drive the gear on the last rotor, it'll do it all in sync. But that's actually relatively easy, because all I have to do is make sure that this gap here lines up with this gap here, and they'll all be in sync. So I put a light coat of paint on these rotors, and the next challenge is going to be where to put the numbers on here. Where does which number go? So I'll start by putting the top of the counter on here, and the numbers obviously have to show up within this window here. But where do we put the 0? Where do we put the 1? So the easiest way to do it is to just increment until they both rotate. And now they both just rotated. So if I'm counting, I must have just rotated up to 0. So let's just make sure we're in the middle of the detent. And that tells me now 0 goes here. And just to make sure I'm not going to get the direction wrong, I'm going to mark where the 1 goes as well. So going up by 1, there's the 1, just in case I end up putting it on in the wrong direction. I could add the numbers by gluing the numbers on a piece of paper onto my rotors, but I don't want to do that. I actually want to paint them on here, but I'm going to use these as a guide for where they go, which is why I printed these as a mirror image, so that I'm going to attach these like so and then rub them through. So let's take this rotor out again. So what I wanted to do was to just wrap this around and then rub all the digits through, but it turns out my scale is not entirely bang on. I didn't make these rotors as precise as I should, and so I end up with a little bit of drift. So what I'm going to do is just take one digit at a time, center it on the tick mark, and I've added tick marks for every digit around the rotor. So here's the one for 0, and I'll just rub that one through. And I don't really need to get the whole thing, I'm just trying to get the shape. See, there's the 1, so let's center that. I need to move it a little wee bit. Let's rub that one in. And center the 2. So you can see the digits quite well already. So I've put the rotors back in here, and let's put the cover on here. And we've got the 8 here, 9, and then as we wrap to the 0, this one should move. Yep. So these are good. I can go ahead and paint those on. Now to mark the positions on the next rotor, I'm just going to spin this one by hand. There's the next position, and I know that's 0 because this one moved, which makes this one 1. Okay, back to 0. Now I need to do this one, and rather than turning this one by 1,000 digits, I'm just going to take one of these gears out so that now I can rotate this one independently. And let's mark the last rotor. So there's a digit. And because this last one isn't driving another digit, we can put the 0 anywhere we want to. So now I'm just going to use some acrylic paint to paint these digits on much better. Now a thing about painting with acrylics, or else for that matter, is it's not the size of your brush that determines the level of detail that you can paint, it's the quality of the brush. So I've put my rotors in there with the washers in between. And I'm checking here that this is the right size. I just cut my base to the right size. And now let's see how that lid fits on there. I haven't cut that to final size yet. So just to make sure everything fits together. So I should cut that here, And this is just about flush. So I figured these 1.5 inch number 6 screws would be a good length to use. And in terms of drill size, if I hold the shank of this drill in front of my screw, I can still see the thread is sticking out on either side. So that should be a good drill for a pilot hole for this screw. So I'm going to drill that pilot hole through both pieces just to make sure I've got the alignment perfect. I'm now going to drill a larger shank hole just through the top layer so that the screw is actually going to pull the pieces together. I'm trying to keep all the mechanism visible as possible, but just to give it a little bit of lateral stability, I'm going to add this block in here, and that makes sure nothing can tip sideways. So I've just varnished all the pieces, and one more thing I'm going to add is I want to have a knob on the outside for spinning the first rotor, so I put a little screw in here at an angle to lock the shaft against this rotor, and then that goes against the first side, and I've got a knob that's going to go on here, and just like the other one, I have the screw here at an angle for locking this knob onto here. So I've got the increment-decrement mechanism put together here. So let's put the shaft in the first rotor in here. And there's a little washer that goes right behind it. And now the middle rotor. Another washer. And the last rotor, and another washer, and now the final side. These all spin nicely, so I can screw that together. Now to get the small gears in, I have to make sure these digits all line up with a proper digit. And then put these in here. The flat part goes against here. It's best not to use 9 or 0 for the digits that you're selecting on the top, just to keep it easier down here. And so let's put this one in. And let's see, that increments where it's supposed to. And let's bring it down to 0 here. And that carries to all the digits. Good. Now let's attach this knob here with the screw at an angle that locks it in. So I've just installed the rubber band for the detent and this little hook thing, and now it's all together. So 999 0 1 2 7 8 9 10, and it counts backwards too. And to quickly reset it, I can just turn a knob.